Subcommittee of the Health and Human Services Committee. And before we begin, I'd like to ask Senator Setzler to open us in prayer. What's your mind?
Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, giver of all good things, we just praise you and thank you for all that you're doing in our lives. We pray, Lord, that we would be mindful of the least of these, Lord, that you've called us to serve and be mindful of. Pray that we would humble ourselves before you, pray that you give us the wisdom that only you can give. Bless these proceedings today, that we would ask hard questions, that we would understand truth when we hear it, and seek to glorify you in all we do. We pray this in your holy name. Amen.
Thank you, Senator. So we have one bill on our agenda today, House Bill 520. It's for a hearing only. We're not voting on this bill today. The bill crossed over from the House just over a week ago, and time is short before the end of the session. We have committee members with multiple conflicts, and so we have a hard stop at 3 o'clock today. Because of that, we're gonna have the House sponsors present the bill, have questions from the committee, and then we'll take as much public testimony as we have time for. Because of the public interest on both sides of this bill, we're gonna ask everyone to keep their comments to 2 minutes or less, and we'll notify you when you have 30 seconds remaining once you're recognized. If someone has already made your point, feel free to waive your time. And please identify yourself when you go to the podium, which is right over there. If you signed up and don't get to speak, you can submit written testimony, and we'd be happy to distribute that to the subcommittee. In the Senate, our rules require decorum and respect for each other. So we won't be able to have cheering, clapping, or shouting, and please don't block anybody else's line of sight. The hearing is being live streamed on the legislative website, and it's also visible on the TVs outside of the committee room. So with that, we're gonna have the bill presented, starting with Representative Jones, Chairman Jones, and Representative Oliver. Is it number one? Witness one?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, the floor is yours.
Can you hear me? Okay, perfect. Thank you very much, Madam Chairwoman. What would be the, I'll say, first indicators or second indicators of mental health or substance abuse? Madam Chairwoman, that is the end of my comments.
Thank you, and I know you're gonna have to leave, but we're gonna go ahead, Representative Oliver, if you could cover the other sections, and then if you're willing to take all the questions, that'd be great.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I'm very happy to be here, and I appreciate the privilege of presenting another opportunity for the state to move forward on mental health reform. What is different this year than was presented to you in 1013? I'd like to take just a moment to talk about that. In 1013, we came to the General Assembly with a number of different recommendations that came from the Behavioral Health and Innovation Commission, chaired by Kevin Tanner.
And Madam Chair, I raised the question because the delegation that happens here and the agency is going to be they're going to get about their business quickly. They're going to define this by December of 23. Important things are going to hinge on that definition, and it seems to me that is the province of the General Assembly to determine those kinds of if legally significant things are going to hinge on a definition. You know, we're in the business when we do our good work. And I know you've seen good work here, you've seen bad work here.
I've seen them.
When we do our good work, we write definitions that because so much hinges on. I'm concerned a delegation that's going to have this much impact legally, and there's other settings we don't have time to talk through. That's that's a concern.
I think you're raising an interesting issue that I have not thought about in terms of the definition of severe mental illness in your perception, or perhaps serious mental illness, and perhaps impacting the issue of capacity to stand trial or the issue of granting of a guardianship for 1013. And I'm happy to take those questions back to the folks that work most in forensic and give you some more time and examples and understanding of that if it'd be helpful to you or the committee.
Yes, Representative, one of the things that has come up throughout the bill is referring to definitions that haven't been developed yet, and we're pretty protective in the General Assembly about defining things, and certainly happy to look at proposals from agencies for definitions, but I suspect that that may be one thing we'll be working on, is being sure that we retain control of that process. We do have definitions of mental illness and substance abuse in the law, so this would be something different. I think at that point, we're going to stop and go ahead and take some public testimony, because I know there are a lot of people who drove a long way to get down here, and we'd like to hear from as many people as we can. And this is not the last opportunity for people to weigh in, and certainly we will take written testimony, as I mentioned at the very beginning. Let me just remind you, we're going to limit individuals to 2 minutes just because we've got a long list of people signed up, and we may not get to everybody today. And we'll get started with, Hank Sullivan.
The lead sponsor for the bill owns a company who stands to benefit from its passing. That is because he owns a monitoring company that does monitoring that is described in the bill. He had the same monitoring described in 1013 last year, and thankfully, for the hard work of the Senate, that monitoring aspect was removed. But he stands to gain from this. He and his partner stand to gain from this bill passing, and he's putting funding, and he's putting grants in order to fund these different aspects of health.
Madam Chair, I wonder if that would be appropriate for his testimony to be when Chairman Jones is here. Sounds a little bit unfair.
Chairman Jones had the opportunity to be here.
Do you have line numbers in the bill that you're referring to?
Then you should have stayed.
Start his time again.
Yes.
You can
look at line numbers 551 through 558, 545 through 550. You're going to find that these line numbers deal with professional health care program, defining the professional health care program, and the fact that monitoring and rehabilitation of impaired health care professionals for the purpose of this, that, and the other thing. Impaired means the inability of a health care professional to practice and reasonable skill and safety to patients by reason of illness or use of alcohol, drugs, narcotics, and chemicals. What he's done is he's defined what his product does, which is a monitoring device. It monitors biometrics as well as GPS. So he's defined in the bill what his particular device actually does that's patented. And he's marketed this to Tennessee. It's in three states right now. It's now in Paulding County and in Fulton County. And I'd like for my entire remarks to go to the committee, if I could. All right.
Thank you.
So I apologize that we couldn't hear from everybody. It's that time of the session where we're extremely tied up and our rooms are short and our members have to run off to other committees. So thanks to everyone for coming down. Stay tuned. This is a long process. We're just the beginning of it. Thanks very much. We're adjourned. Thank you.